Welcome back to a brand new video. We have breaking news about massive trades that just happened in the National Football League. It has ramifications for the draft and multiple years after this one. Before we hop into the content of today's video, if you guys are new to the channel, be sure to subscribe and drop a like on the video if you guys do enjoy it. With all that being said, let's hop right into this news and get into the details of these trades. I'm scrolling through Twitter this morning around 1 o'clock, and that's when a massive trade between the San Francisco 49ers and the Miami Dolphins took place. The Miami Dolphins traded the number 3 overall pick to the San Francisco 49ers for the 12th pick in this draft, a 2022 third round pick, a 2022 and 2023 first round pick for the 49ers to go up to number 3 to get their quarterback, and gives the Dolphins the ability to trade down, collect more picks, and even stockpile for the future more than they already have. According to reports, the 49ers are in the quarterback mix now, but they are holding on to Jimmy Garoppolo and have no plans to trade him. Many expected if they're going to trade up this much and do this big of a trade, they're going to be taking a quarterback. But right now, the focus is on Jimmy G to be returning for the 49ers and be the starter for this upcoming season. I still believe the 49ers will be taking either Justin Fields or Trey Lance at number 3. Garoppolo will be the quarterback this season. They'll learn behind Garoppolo and take over in 2022 and the future for the 49ers. There's no way you move up this many slots and give up this much to not take a quarterback at number 3. So the 49ers are going to be taking a quarterback at number 3 now. We know that for pretty certain. And so after this trade, I was kind of shocked. You know, the NBA trade line just happened, and now the NFL is doing all these crazy trades. But it wasn't done. It was not done after this. Then the Miami Dolphins traded again with the Philadelphia Eagles. The Dolphins traded the number 12 pick and their 22 first round pick for the Eagles' 6th overall pick and their 156th pick. So another blockbuster deal between the Dolphins and another team. The Dolphins were absolutely going crazy in the trade market today. They get back inside the top 10 with the Eagles, and the Eagles fall back to number 12. They collect a first round pick for next season, and it looks like they get a higher fourth round pick for this draft. The Eagles try to trade up to get Zach Wilson, but we know the Jets were not going to trade with the Eagles and give up their quarterback who they're most likely going to take. So the Eagles weren't going to trade up with the Dolphins at number 3 if Zach Wilson wasn't going to be there. So instead, they still trade with the Dolphins, but they trade out of the top 10. They collect another first round pick for next year, and they're going to continue their rebuild and building for the future without Carson Wentz and a lot of their Super Bowl players. They're going to have to build with a lot younger roster and a lot more assets now that they have. The Dolphins should be thanking Laremy Tunsil. He is literally a hero for that team. You know, in 2016, when the Dolphins drafted Laremy Tunsil, there was that picture of him with a bong. When many saw him actually being the first overall pick in the draft, he fell all the way outside of the top 10 where the Dolphins drafted him, and they have absolutely maximized his value. They have now traded him for 4 first round picks and a third round pick. It's just unreal how much one event in NFL history can change the course of a franchise. Laremy Tunsil has completely changed the spectrum for the Miami Dolphins. He has changed the history for the Dolphins. It's almost like drafting a top 5 quarterback or a Hall of Fame quarterback. That's what Laremy Tunsil like has done. He's gotten them so much value. He's gotten them so many first round picks, so many, you know, top players now because of, you know, him getting traded. And I think Dolphin fans and, you know, the Dolphins organization in general, they should be so thankful and so happy with Laremy Tunsil. And maybe they should consider putting up a statue of Tunsil outside of the facility for everything he's done for the team. This completely changes the draft order, but I think now the Dolphins may look to take Ja'Marr Chase at number 6 overall. I don't think they really wanted to take a receiver that high at number 3. So now that they move back to number 6, they get an extra first round pick and an extra third round pick. And they're still going to be able to get, you know, one of the players that they like the most at, you know, top 6 in the draft. And I think that's actually going to be Ja'Marr Chase. And a lot of people have been talking about maybe Kyle Pitts to the Dolphins, but I think the Dolphins are going to value more of a run after catch receiver. You know, they already have Mike Gesicki. I don't know if they're going to invest a high pick into a tight end. So my guess is Ja'Marr Chase will be the pick at number 6. I think the Eagles at number 12 are kind of a hard pick now. Many saw them either taking a playmaker. Like I said in yesterday's video, I thought they were going to take, you know, Kyle Pitts at number 6. But now they don't really have that option because he's not going to be falling outside of the top 10. So I don't know if the Eagles are going to take maybe a target that falls, maybe like Smith if he falls out of the top 10, or if they're going to take a quarterback, you know, reach on a Mac Jones at number 12, or what they're thinking there. That's kind of a hard choice, but we already know the 49ers are going to be taking a quarterback at top 3. But this is just crazy NFL news, and I had to break it for you guys and come up with a video to let you guys know the massive trade between the Dolphins, the Eagles, and the 49ers. I think this trade has the Dolphins out on Deshaun Watson or any quarterback trade for, you know, this offseason. I think most people knew that the Dolphins weren't going to make that trade, but I think this confirms it now. I do think, however, this gives the Dolphins security, where if Tua doesn't improve next year or he doesn't take the next step and show the Dolphins good growth from year one to year two, the Dolphins have, you know, a lot of picks where they can still, you know, make a trade for a Deshaun Watson if he becomes available, you know, if he's still in the league come next season. Or they can use this to trade it for the quarterback in next year's draft. So that's kind of what my mindset is. I think the Dolphins made this trade to get some extra picks. I don't think they were going to take who they wanted at number three. So they moved back, got some extra picks. And then I think they're going to use the security of the extra picks that they got to potentially trade for a quarterback if, you know, Tua doesn't show progression and growth. But I do think Tua will have a great season next year. So I think these picks will most likely be used to continue to build their team and get a lot of young assets and players to build one of the best rosters in the league. But anyway, that's all I got for you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching the video. Let me know what you guys think of these trades and what you think the Eagles, the Dolphins, and the 49ers are going to take now at their respective positions. If you guys are new to the channel, be sure to subscribe and drop a like on the video for me, guys, if you guys do enjoy it. We're on the road to 600 subscribers, and every single subscriber helps. So if you guys are new, be sure to hit the subscribe button. I'm going to be coming out with NFL content all offseason long, so be on the lookout for that. And I'll see you guys next time.